get ready to match the stars. From Charlie's Angels, David Doyle. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. From Dallas, Susan Hurley. Gary Murdoch. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Who are the Whistlers?
Trojanaires.
Oh, the Trojanaires? That's a local high school cheering section. A singing group. Oh. All right, shall we have a go at it, friend? Would you
surely
greet George DeMarco, whoever he is? Come on out of here, George. Take your place on the little blue dot there. And let's quickly run down the story of your life. You're a public accountant, right?
That's right. I work in Manhattan. I'm from New Rochelle, New York. And I just want to say hello to my little nephew, Joey, if he's probably watching. He's 1 year old.
He's 1 year old?
Sure.
You accountants don't talk to a plane, do you? 2 and 2? 4. Oh, see, he knows that.
But...
All right. Now, listen, you got a chance at the big money here, George. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said write down your best answer to this. Too tall. Now, if you match the answer that studio audience wrote down most frequently, we give you $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. Then if you match the third, you get $100. Three of our six stars are permitted to offer some assistance.
How about Marcia?
Oh, gosh, why did he pick me, do you suppose?
I don't know.
Well, I being such a jockette.
Yeah.
Too tall Jones.
Yeah! Too tall Jones.
And too tall Jones.
Charles?
Too tall to tango.
Too tall to tango.
And David.
Oh, you rat. You supposed to look away from
no
me.
One
I
else.
I was looking down.
He was looking down.
Too tall.
Everyone
for any
was,
use at all.
Everyone was avoiding your gaze because no one can think of a third answer here.
Well, I don't think it makes any difference anyway.
I don't think it does either. Too tall to tell.
Too tall to tell.
That's onomatopoeia.
Yeah. Well, he says it doesn't make any difference anyway. He's made up his mind even before David gave his answer. What do you say?
Too tall Jones.
Too tall Jones.
What is another too tall?
Now, can there be anything else that's really popular?
Didn't he pick too tall to tell?
No, no. Too tall Jones.
Good luck.
All right, may we see the $100 response. Too tall for his age. Your mother and father say that all the time to you. I know that. Let's take a look at the next one. Attaboy, Chuck.
Too tall to tango.
Oh, all right. Last chance for Too Tall Jones. Here it is. All right.
Thank you.
Now, listen. George, the $500 got you a kiss on the cheek.
Well, no. I didn't plan it one on the lips, but he looked funny with red lips.
Oh, I see. All right. That means at least you'll play for us $5,000. On second thought, go give her a real kiss on the lips there. Well.
It must be.
All right. Now give us your accounting.
Yeah. Now how much is 2 and 2?
Yeah.
All right. 5,000 is... Oh, listen. You look wonderful. I could call for Kleenex, but I'm not going to. At least you play for is $5,000, but you get a lucky spin of the wheel, you play for $10,000. Here we go. Good luck to you. Let's all root for a double.
Let's talk about it for me. It is going to be me. Oh, God, help me. I know it is. Oh, God.
$5,000 with Susan Howard. Good luck to you. Here we go. Production blank. Production blank. Well, she made up her mind very quickly. Now, you think about it. Take your time if you want to, George. Give us the answer that Susan's written on that card. We give you $5,000. What do you say?
Production manager.
Production manager. All right. Susan, he says production manager.
Oh, you know, the idea is really to go for the first thing. You know, if you really
right,
go,
that's
I
what we say.
Production line.
Yeah. Production
that's
line.
That's the first thing that I thought.
Well, that's been in the publicity a great deal with the automobile companies having the problems they're having. So production line is a popular production thing. Company would have been another good one. Well, George, you've got $500. You're going to have one more shot at it as you play game number two. Let's bring Calamity Jane Max back here. Calamity Jane Max. All right. You remember Calamity Jane? Now, review the story of your life briefly for us, for those who might not have been with us last time, please.
Well, I'm originally from Winchester, Tennessee. And I live in El Monte, California. I'm married. I have an 11-year-old son. My daddy named me Calamity Jane because I was supposed to be a boy, and I wouldn't. I was a girl, so that made me a calamity.
Yes. I don't think you're a calamity. I think you're a very attractive lady.
Thank
Good
you.
Luck to both of you. Here we go. Calamity, you may have A or B's.
B.
B it is. Horrible Hank is really horrible.
Hi, Horrible Hank.
Well done, I must say. At dinner... He's the only guy in the world who slurps his blank.
Let's see that again.
There you go. Now, Jane, or Calamity. What do your friends call you, Calamity or Jane?
Jane.
Jane. Mm-hmm. Horrible Hank is really horrible. At dinner, he's the only guy in the world who slurps his blank.
Coffee.
Coffee. We're thinking you, hoping you'd say something other than a liquid. People can slurp any liquid, but something else might not be slurpable. A napkin, see, is hard to slurp. There's a good, anything that's not slurpable.
But darling, I understand that Prince Philip slurps his coffee.
Well, sure he does.
Smoking. Don't, I said he slurped his mashed potatoes.
Man, another good one. I had two good ones so far.
Jell-O,
a very good one. Oh, the upper tiers come through with some winners there, lower
Thank
tier.
Thank you very much.
The only guy in the world who slurps is what, Susan?
Oh, he slurps steak.
His steak? Very hard to do. Another very good one. Excellent.
His mashed potatoes on CBS yes. and other stations around
right.
the country.
What would be difficult to slurp, Marcia?
Likewise, myself, your basic Jell-O.
Jell-O. So we had excellent responses over there. You'll have a shot at your first round question a moment right after this for you. Thank you. Here we go. The other round, one question for George. Sally said, my dog has lost his mind. This morning I caught him trying to put on my blank. All right, George. Here we go. Sally said, my dog has lost his mind. This morning I caught him trying to put on my blank.
How about brassiere?
Wait a minute. Brassiere is Brassiere. Your answer. All right. Oh, you did change your mind?
Yes.
All right, David.
Paris on air, went with pantyhose.
Pantyhose, excellent.
David and I have matched so much this week, haven't we, darling?
We certainly have, dear.
Just adorable. I started to write tuxedo, but then I realized you said Sally, and there was nothing wrong with Sally. So I said pantyhose.
That's two of those. What's a cowboy say?
Why? We said it because all three of us are wearing them. Panties.
Really?
Oh, dear, he is cute, isn't he?
Secret is out.
Wouldn't they be surprised if we said, okay, show and tell.
Show us your underalls.
Yes. Ready, David?
Sure, anytime.
Oh, thanks.
All right, Susan. Sally said, my dog's lost his mind. This morning I caught him trying to put on my...
Well, my dog likes to chew on my shoes. So if
he... Shoes.
Yes.
Put on your shoes, yes. Did you teach him to chew on your shoes?
Didn't have to. He came that way.
Oh.
Yes.
It's natural.
Yes.
Huh? Yeah.
Plain old, ordinary, garden variety overcoat. I didn't know what to
Overcoat,
think.
Yeah. What was your first answer?
My first answer was sheep's clothing. I had absolutely no... A dog in sheep's clothing.
Yeah.
See, I was really reaching for it, Gene.
Yeah. Well,
it's like
we were
this.
Thinking of any item of clothing that Sally would wear.
Did you say Sally?
Yeah.
See, I didn't hear that part either.
I thought you
said...
You
didn't
I
hear
you
Sally?
A fella.
I didn't hear Sally.
No, I
obviously...
Well, then, obviously, you're going to have a rotten
Sally?
Answer, too, just as he had.
Wait a minute. That's not fair.
Yours was a rotten answer. Let's face
We've known each other for a long time. We've
yes,
been
we
very
have,
good friends. There's no
and
need
that.
To ruin that just over a game
well,
show.
Well, no, we can be friends and all that.
No,
we can be friends, but I just say you get a rotten answer, that's all. And
And you
see? Well, I love your suit.
Don't hold back.
Somebody in the back row had a good idea. They said, let's get on with it.
See, I didn't realize you said Sally until his fabulous answer, brassiere.
Oh.
So I said tie. Because it was a wonderful image.
Yes.
Is it a doctor not a little tie doing a little knot?
You must listen to me. Hello. Now we'll go to round two. This is the final round. Score is tied. She went first last time. You go first this time.
I'll pick B.
B, isn't this a tight game? Albert says.
Wait a minute. Albert? Is that a boy or a girl?
Albert.
Oh, Albert. Okay. Alberta.
So you know you're living too close to an atomic reactor when you wake up in the morning and discover your husband has three blanks.
I don't understand.
Here we go, George. Albert said, you know you're living too close to an atomic reactor when you wake up in the morning and discover your husband has three blanks.
Eyes.
Perfectly good answer.
Right?
Three eyes, he said.
Well, three eyes is as good as mine. Three heads.
All right.
I don't think that question makes any sense, but then, of course, neither does my answer. Three hot cross buns.
The correct answer, Uncle Jim.
Three eyes. Very good, Charles. George, you've got one. Susan, you know you're living too close to an atomic reactor. When you wake up in the morning, you discover your husband has three...
George has got two eyes.
All right. What do you say, sir?
The eyes have it.
The eyes have it. Another one. Three for George. Do you make it four?
I'm crazy about him. I love his shade of lipstick. It's fabulous.
Yeah.
But I said noses. It's close.
Yes. All right. It's on the face there somewhere.
It doesn't make any sense.
Now, Jane.
I never should.
You need three to tie, four to win. The motel desk clerk.
Yes,
the motel
desk clerk.
A boy or a girl?
I have to get their attention with those first phrases.
The old donkey joke. First, you have to hit them.
Right. The motel desk clerk said, that last guy was really strange.
How strange was he?
He checked in with a blank. Jane, the motel desk clerk said, that last guy was really strange. He checked in with a blank.
With a horse?
With a horse.
I'm trying.
You really are in Hollywood, you know.
I know.
And they do strange things out here, but I think a horse is a bit much.
Not for Tennessee, I bet.
How many motels have you been here lately?
I've seen horses in this state. I mean, replicated by a mannequin.
A mannequin, right. He checked in with a mannequin. Good response, yes.
No, I saw him. He was staying in the room next to us in Encino's. Oh, pardon.
The Encino Arms?
Anyway, he checked in with a Greyhound bus.
Checked in with a Greyhound bus. All right.
I don't know why. I just felt this way.
Yes?
Checked in with a llama.
A llama. Oh.
I don't know why.
What a lovely thought. Yes.
How does one just feel that way? I don't understand it.
All right. Now, Jane, you've got to match a lower tier here to stay in the game. May we see it, Susan?
No way. Dog.
Hey, dog, what'd you have?
A roadrunner.
A roadrunner and a coyote. We had six different responses. Come on down, George. Right there.
You are getting calamity. Can you turn your feet around?
Well, Jane didn't win any money, but we're going to send her an antique meatloaf. Thank you very much for being with us, my dear. It was a pleasure to do business. Calamity Jane. Now this message for you. Here for the second time, and he's going to have another go at the big money, and we wish him well. George, we polled the studio audience, a very smart bunch like these. And we said to that bunch, we said, write down your best answer to this. Built for blank. Now, if you give us the answer they wrote down most frequently, we'll give you $500, remember? 250 for the second most popular and 100 for the third. Whom do you want over here?
Brett.
How about Built for Action? That's what they always said about me, hon.
Sure. Oh, boy, did they ever.
Charles?
There's another one, famous one, Built. I'm sorry.
Well, he's looked all around. He can't find it. Built for Beauty. Something you know nothing
That's
about.
That's it. This sweet child. Stand up, sweetheart. What's your name? Excellent. What is it again? My memory. Got it. This is the one I feel very strong about. Built for Comfort.
Yeah. Oh, thank
you.
Yeah.
You rat.
How about Susan?
You
How
rat.
About Susan?
Well, just to show you, she has a second one.
Uh-huh.
Because Johnny gave me that one. Built for two.
Built for two. Uh-huh.
Built for two.
A bicycle
built for
built
action
for two?
And built for comfort are the three they've given you. Now, you can choose one of those or think up one of your own.
Well, I'd like to kiss Susan next. I'll say built for two.
Oh, sure.
All right.
Sure, how quickly
very fickle.
That doesn't mean you're a bad kisser, Marcia.
Sir, break my heart. Toss me aside. Go on to the blonde. Sure.
Well, no, but he's tried you.
Well, your lipstick is still on the man's
Now
face.
He wants
well,
to try her.
My lipstick's still on his mouth.
Yeah.
Here, darling, use my shoulder to cry on. Poor little thing. Just when she thought she'd found Mr. Wright.
I'll kiss you.
Who was that woman?
All right, here we go, George. He's chosen built for two. Let's built for, no, you said built
for two.
Oh, you said built for two, yeah. Let's take a look at the $100 response. Built for comfort. That was Charles' answer. The next one says, built for speed. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, look at
it. Uh-oh. Last chance for built for two. Go. Whoa! Now.
I'm not saying a word.
Two-timer. Somebody always call you a two-timer.
You tell him, hon.
Listen.
No.
Which one is a better kisser? Tell me. Because I...
They were both terrific.
Oh, all right.
At least you have some tact, you scoundrel.
You're going to go fire on your business. I can tell you that right now.
Right, baby.
Now, George, you got $500. Means at least you'll play for us $5,000. However, you are going to spin the wheel again and see if you can double it up to $10,000. Good luck to you. Here we go.
Just don't let it be me. Don't let it be me. Oh, no. Don't let it be me. Okay.
Yeah!
Yeah! Hot tonic!
Ho. What is that? Double, $10,000 is what he's playing for. Good luck. Here we go. Chuck, you ready? All right, cowboy, here it is. Give it blank. Just take a look at it. I'll go show it to Charles and make sure that we all understand each other here.
Are we in the jungle or what? Honestly, I'm getting unnerved at my age.
Charles is ready. Now, if you match Charles, you get $10,000. What do you say?
Give it your all.
Give it your all. All right.
Give it your all.
Now, I remind you that here, when we go for the big money, it has to be an exact match.
George, Chuck. I really am sorry. I said give it a try.
Give it a try. Well, listen. George, you have $1,000, and that's not bad. Have a good time with the mic. Thank you for being here on MatchCam. George DeMarco. Now this message for America.
I don't know about
Will you all come back again sometime?
Jane. Just ask me.
Will you? Yes.
Brett's sister's here with...
Oh!
Terry's here, and it's lovely. It's just...
Jerry? Yes, dear.
Cherry is her name?
No, Jerry.
Jerry.
Oh.
Jerry.
Oh, you scared
She's
me
here then. With her practical
Jerry
nurse.
Jerry from Maine. Jerry, what's her name?
Jerry.
She's here with her practical nurse, and she's supposed to be the better of the two sisters. So
All right. Oh, it's your younger sister. I see that. Gene Reberter, join us next time in the Match Game. Goodbye.
Some of our contestants will receive Hamilton's Jolin, silver dial with 10 genuine diamonds on the case. Bracelet is mesh and replaceable with adjustable lock from Hamilton. And beautiful sweepstakes carpeting from Galaxy Carpet Mills features Encolon nylon with Scotch Guard, Galaxy sweepstakes, and 10 contemporary colors. And have you noticed your nails lately? Buff them to a brilliant no-polish shine with Nail Buffs, the nail treatment for the whole family. Nail Buffs by Terrace of Springfield, Massachusetts. And Geranimals matching tag fashions. Children's wear famous for the quality, fit, and fashion that mothers insist on. Geranimals for boys and girls, infants to teens. And Simply Superior long-lasting glycerin soap. 12 exciting fragrances and different transparent colors. Gently moisturizes as it cleans. Simply Superior glycerin soap.
Program is edited for broadcast.